meeting fortune tellers to undertaking the Amarnath Yatra and interviewing none other than Narendra Modi, the South Asia Bureau Chief of The Economist, Adam Roberts, has had an interesting few weeks in the run-up to his special report on India. It's a pleasure to have with us here in the studio Adam to share his insights and views on the politics and economics of the country. Adam, many thanks for making time to be with us here on We Mean Business.
You're very welcome.
Let me first start by asking you, what was more interesting, the Amarnath Yatra or Narendra Modi's interview?
They were both fantastic in their different ways.
All right. Let's try and understand and your insights into the economic and political situation sure. that India finds itself in right now. Economically speaking, a lot has happened over the last few weeks.
Yeah.
And I believe you took 5 weeks off to write your special report.
Yes.
Your sense of how significant the developments over the last few weeks have been with regard to this whole push to the reform process?
Well, obviously, the timing from my point of view was very good to have
right.
the reforms come just before the end of writing the special report. We were very pleased to see the changes that were made. We were pleased both with the rise in the diesel price, but also with the other reforms announced on foreign investment in aviation, in retail, and the other elements of the reforms. And having welcomed that, we would like to sort of praise the government for doing it.
Right.
But that said, we don't feel that it has gone anywhere far enough to turn around the situation for India's economy in the next year or two. It really is not enough yet. There has to be more if you're going to please the credit rating agencies and deal with the structural problems that are still there.
So too little, too late, is that the right way to sum it up?
I suppose too late is certainly true. It
right.
should have happened ideally 3 or 4 years ago, some of these things. The diesel price, for example, could have been taken out of the hands of politicians and allowed to rise gradually and slowly, and the pain would have been less hard felt by ordinary Indians today. So clearly it should have come earlier. And yes, too little so far. There should be more reforms. There hopefully will be more reforms to come to raise confidence in India's economy.
Right. One of the criticisms that the opposition parties have really talked about in trying to oppose the reform process is that our economist prime minister was very unhappy with his criticism in the foreign media, citing specifically, for instance, the Time magazine cover or the Washington Post article
yeah.
or other pieces that have been written
yeah.
by various publications, including The Economist,
absolutely.
Of course, that have been very critical of the fact that here is an economist prime minister who could not push through India's reform process.
Yeah.
Do you think that played a significant part? He clearly did not want to go down in history as an economist, as a reformist who could not push forward any critical reforms during his tenure.
I wouldn't overplay how important we are as commentators. I think we have a role to play, as you do in the domestic media, to raise a mirror to Indian society, to Indian politicians, and tell them where we think they're going wrong. And clearly we will be read as the foreign press rather more carefully, and it may affect foreign investors and so on. But I think if I were Manmohan Singh, I would say there would be many, many other pressures that would be driving me to get on with these things. Number one, and most important, would be a concern for my fellow Indians. If he knows it's the right thing to do to get the economy growing faster, to tackle the poverty, the great problems that have to be solved in India, then he should do it. He shouldn't do it because of some editorial in an American or a British magazine. That
Absolutely.
Really is not the most important thing for him to care about. He should do it because it's right. And he needs to have the guts, I think, to carry on doing things because they're right, not just because it's politically expedient or because he cares about his legacy. He should be motivated to act because he thinks it'll benefit Indians. And that's what we're arguing. We're saying do these things because it's good for you. It's good for India. It makes India a stronger, richer, more confident place. And that's what we want to see.
It's all right that people like you understand it, people like us understand
yeah.
it, but does the average Indian really understand India's reform process? And are we really simplifying the word reform? You've actually travelled across the country and you've been around for now 2 years, but the last 5 weeks extensively trying to talk to people, getting a sense of what they really expect out of
yeah.
our top policymakers. Do you get a sense that they really understand the political and the economic compulsions of the government?
Well, I think if you ask the question in that way, then the idea that the average voter in India understands the abstract arguments of how economics works and how the political system intermingles with the economy, then the answer would be no. But I do believe that Indians often have a gut instinct. They have an understanding of whether the economy is strong or whether it's not doing well, whether there's some difficult measures that might need to be taken in order to keep the economy growing in the way that it was growing for the past 8 years or so. And I think I wouldn't talk down the ability of an ordinary Indian voter to grasp that sometimes you have to go through a difficult period in the short term in order to see the benefits in the long term. And I think often politicians look down at their voters and don't give them enough respect and believe that they can understand, just as you would understand in your own household or in your own finances, that maybe you have to make a sacrifice today in order to benefit later. One of the things I was most struck by in doing the research for the report was looking at education and how much Indian parents are prepared to sacrifice and to spend on helping their children get a better education. Those are people who understand that you invest today to benefit later. And I think that's true of people in villages, people in remote parts of India, people in the cities. They understand this. And politicians should trust that and should be willing to try to explain it in a simple way to say that if other countries can prosper by doing these things, so can India.
India's number one news app just got even better. Download NDTV's new app, fully optimized for retina display, full screen view, faster response time, and Sudoku. NDTV's new iPad app. Download now.